Hello and welcome to Driving with Todd, and I'm Todd. Ringo Starr released an album in March of 1970 called Sentimental Journey. Now, that was really kind of the first album put out by a Beatle prior to the Beatles breaking up. Now, John Lennon already had left the band in late 1969, and Paul McCartney was going to announce that he was leaving the band and breaking the band up about 2 months after the Instant Karma single came out. But Ringo Starr knew all this was happening and didn't want to be left alone out in the cold. So with the urging of the other three Beatles, he was going to record an album and release that and hopefully start a solo career. Well, he was going to put out a country album, but talking with his parents, he thought, you know what I want to do is put out an album of old standards, because his parents thought he had a really good voice. And his mom had a lot of favorite songs from like the 40s and the 50s and the early 60s. So that's what he was going to do. He was going to do his mom's favorite songs that were old standards. So this was something new. I remember when the album came out, I didn't buy it. I mean, I was a huge Beatles fan, and I kind of like, I'm staying away from this album. I'm not an old standards favorite, even though my dad would play this stuff all the time. But my friend Ron, he lived up the block from me. He had a nice stereo. I mean, really nice stereo system, and he bought a lot of records. So, you know, he bought it. I listened to it, and I just couldn't get into it. Today, though, I think it's a great album. I thought, this is really some good stuff. And what's funny about this is he was kind of treading on new ground. A rock and roll star doing old standards. Well, nowadays, every rock and roll star does old standards. I mean, Rod Stewart did, what, like three albums of that? Linda Ronstadt did like three albums of that in the 80s. And more artists are getting into looking at the music from the 40s, 50s, and 60s, early 60s, as like classic music, and they're putting their own spin on those records. So Ringo Starr was pretty much ahead of the times. So each one of the songs that were on this album were arranged by different people. Basically, it was sort of produced by George Martin. George Martin kind of oversaw the project, but each song was arranged by different people. Quincy Jones arranged a song, and other big stars arranged songs. Klaus Voormann arranged a song, and so on and so forth. So I thought the one we would do is Night and Day. Like that song, I think it's a great song. And like I said, today, that whole album is really, really good. There's not really a bad song on there. And Ringo's voice is actually pretty good on this album. I think he's better doing rock and roll. I mean, I saw Ringo Starr and his all-star band live, and he was dynamite on stage. Just loved his stage presence. But I think as classics and old standards, I think he does a really good job. I mean, his voice is really smooth on this album. So here we go with Ringo Starr doing Night and Day from the album Sentimental Journey.
Night and day, you are the one. Only you beneath the moon and under the sun. Whether near to me or far, it's no matter, darling, where you are, I think of you. Night and day, day and night, why is it so that this longing for you follows wherever I go? Traffic's boom, in the silence of my lonely room, I think of you. Night and day, night and day, under the height of me, there's oh such a hungry yearning burning inside of me. Spend my life.
I mean, this is just a, I mean, to me, this is like a great jazz song. That bass guitar in there is just booming. And that jazz piano that's going on in there, I mean, those two things are just like, wow. This is like being in a nightclub and you're sitting there in this smoky room. Everybody's kind of drinking their drinks and he's on stage doing this song. I mean, it's just that kind of atmosphere in this song. And then they got that great orchestra over the top of it. I mean, that's what makes these such great standards, is the orchestra arrangements on these songs. And his voice, like I said, I think his voice is just dandy on the song. It fits it just perfectly. So let's keep on going. But listen to that bass and that piano. I mean, that is just wild. Just wild.
I spend my life making love to you day and night. Night and day. It's torment won't be through till you let me spend my life making love to you day and night. Night and day. Day and night. Night and day.
Wow, even the ending, that was hot. I mean, that was hot. I mean, I don't, like I said, I don't think I would have appreciated this album in March 1970 when it came out. I saw it on the shelves. I said, wow, it's Ringo Starr, but I hear it's like old people's music. And that's pretty much what I put through my mind. And I said, I don't know if I want to spend the money on that. And then, like I said, my friend Ron bought it and we listened to it. It was like, no, I think I'll stay away from that. And it wasn't until I was collecting a lot of Beatles memorabilia in the late 70s that I actually bought the album and listened to it. And again, I didn't really care for it. I listened to it because it was Ringo Starr. It was a Beatle. I had to have it. I put it on the shelf. And it wasn't until probably it came out on CD in the mid-90s that I really appreciated this album. When I bought the CD and listened to it, it was like, this is really good. This is good stuff. And his next album, Buku of Blues, he actually did his country album. So, you know, he did his standards, then he did his country album, and then he did the album that just, you know, made him famous, which was the Ringo album that had all the hits on it. You know, really standards, country, and then back to rock and roll, where he kind of started. So love this song. What he did, a great version. I think his voice was just dynamite on this song. It just fits so perfectly. And the orchestration, the bass guitar, even that sax solo in the center. I mean, this whole thing was just so well done. The arrangement was excellent. So I really like it. I hope you really like it. If you liked Ringo Starr doing Night and Day from the Sentimental Journey album, hit the like button. That'd be really cool. If you have any comments about Ringo Starr, the song Night and Day, or the album Sentimental Journey, put it in the comments below. That'd be really cool. And if you haven't done so, subscribe to my channel. Just do it right now. Hit that subscribe and ring the bell, and you'll get updates to my latest videos. So my day's over with. I'm done doing videos. I'm hoping you enjoyed this video. And if you did, I hope it put a big smile on your face. And peace out, baby.